Scorpion News is a public forum for student expression. Students make all content decisions, and opinions do not necessarily represent those of the HUSD. What's up, Scorpions? I'm Caitlin Espinoza, your anchor for this week's broadcast. We're wrapping up Spirit Week on Friday. It's sports day, so make sure to wear your gear from your favorite team. We have a winter sports pep rally during lunch in the quad. Come swing by. The Avid program is taking donations for pet supplies to help our local shelters. Please drop off items to student support or room S30 by Tuesday, December 14th. Check the flyers around campus for more details on needed items. Scorpions, please come claim any lost and found items in the library by this Wednesday, December 8th. Unclaimed items will be donated to the Salvation Army. Yearbooks are still on sale at the lowest price of the year. Go to the student store to purchase yours for only $70 with an activities card and $80 without. The yearbook could be great to look back on memories, like all the music we listened to this year. Good thing we have Spotify. I heard we all got our Spotify wrapped this year. Root and Starlin put together a video for you.
Every year, Spotify releases an analysis of their users' music listening data called Spotify Wrapped. Many people look forward to this every year because it's a great way to subtly show off your music taste to others and brag about how big of a fan you are of an artist. But of course, there are some songs that we are embarrassed to have streamed many, many times. Some of the data might have been influenced by the pandemic because many people definitely listened to more emotional songs in quarantine when they were in their feels. We interviewed some students to see what songs and artists were found on their lists.
Before you received your Spotify Wrapped, which artist did you think would be number one?
I honestly thought it would be this band, this Spanish rock band called Hombres G, just because like I listen to it quite a lot. Or Akon.
I mainly thought it would be like Bruno Mars and Sam Smith, like Ed Sheeran, because lately I've been listening to a lot of that for like the past couple months.
To be honest, I felt we called this goth band up. I can't pronounce it because I just thought it would be them, honestly. Okay.
Who was your number one top artist and what was your number one song?
My top artist was Google, and then my top song was Day and Night.
My top artist was Anthony Ramos with the and the song was Shooter by Clipping.
Well, for me, the top artist was Billie Eilish, ironically. And the song I listened to was surprisingly called More Power. Surprisingly, it is because I listened to the song once. Since last month.
How do you think the pandemic affected your results?
I'm not sure. I feel like it was the same last year. I think the only difference was that I had more anime songs, kind of. Or well, no, it was about the same, but I just had more songs in general because I didn't really listen to Spotify that much. I don't really listen to a lot now, but it was just like I listened to it like 1 minute more than I usually do.
During the pandemic, I was more of like listening to the same stuff over and over again. I never really liked listening to the music, but lately I've been like trying to expand my reach.
If you weren't satisfied with your Spotify Wrapped this year, then better get to listening. This is Root
and Starlin
signing off.
I was excited when Spotify released the annual Wrapped. I think I listened to way too much Olivia Rodrigo. Now getting into the Christmas spirit, I've been loving the Christmas music, and if you do too, you should go check out Choir's concert. Their concert is next Tuesday, December 14th. We got a behind the scenes of them getting ready for their performance. Take a look.
The Christmas concert is next week. Choir has been working hard and are so excited to share their work with you. This concert will feature the HHS choirs, concert choir, treble choir, and select ensemble, and soloists for each choir. The concert will be held off campus at Asperia Church of the Nazarene at 6 p.m. on Tuesday, December 14th. Admission to the concert is free for all ages. Here's a sample of their performance. Scorpion News, this is Gabby signing off.
Great evening, everyone. Looking forward to the performance. Back to the announcements. We are fast approaching the end of the first semester, so be sure to stay on track academically. If you need extra help, be sure to come to weekly tutoring. You can come to the library from 7:45 a.m. to 8:35 a.m. on Mondays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. This is important right before finals week. Check your grades on Infinite Campus. And don't slack off, even if your class might have a sub. Take it easy on them, just like Adele said. Here's a skit made by our broadcast team.
Yo, do we have a sub today?
Yeah, I think Mr. Bernard's out today.
I think that's our sub right there.
That sub looks exactly like Mr. Bernard.
Hey, can you guys all please quiet down while I take attendance?
Anyways, oh yeah, so I went to the Winter Festival.
The sand was so big.
Yeah, he was. You know, the line was actually pretty long.
Was it?
Yeah, I was trying to get a picture. How was it?
It was good.
Hey,
do you think you can stay in your seat, please? Everyone, can you guys just like please go easy on me today?
So anyway,
great acting, Swaggy B. Sorry Tomcat made you cry. I'll talk to him. If you want to see more acting or want to act, auditions for Little Shop of Horrors will be held Thursday, January 6th and Friday, January 7th. I might be there. I don't know. I think I can see pretty
well. No, you can't.
Yeah, I can.
Are you okay? I think you need a break to come back to your senses. Let's see how common sense is on campus.
Imagine you're sinking in a rowboat surrounded by sharks. How do you survive?
I don't know. Start swimming?
Sinking rowboat by sharks? Hop on the shark. I don't know.
I get on a shark and I ride a shark.
Alright.
No, ma'am.
How much dirt is there in a hole 3 feet deep, 6 foot long, and 4 foot wide?
I don't know. I can't even do the math, honestly. So,
3 feet, 6. Explain that again.
How much dirt is there in a hole 3 feet deep?
3 feet.
6 foot long and 4 foot wide.
How many?
much dirt is in that?
Yeah.
I don't know. I can't do this.
3 feet of dirt, 6 feet wide.
Make no sense. My man.
Hexagon has how many sides?
Six. A what? Six?
I don't know. Eight. Oh, that's an octagon. Yeah. It has six or seven. All right.
That is amazing. Wow.
A broken clock is right how many times a day? Can you repeat that? 12?
A broken clock is right how many times a day?
Yes.
Two?
Well, that's it for me. I'm sending it over to Sabrina for sports. This is Caitlin signing off.
Bonjour, Scorpions. I'm Sabrina with this week's sports announcements. Hey, would you like to hear a joke before I start off with announcements? Why did Cinderella get kicked off the baseball team? Because she ran away from the ball. Okay, fine. I guess that wasn't funny. Let's start off with some sport announcements. Today we have a girls' soccer game against Silverado here at HHS starting at 3 p.m., a boys' soccer game against Adelanto at home JV starting at 3 p.m., and varsity starting at 5 p.m. Then we have a wrestling match against Oak Heels here at HHS. Tomorrow, girls' soccer has a game against Bakersfield Varsity at 4:45. We then have a boys' basketball match against St. John Bosco Tourney at TBA and another boys' basketball game at Serrano. On Saturday, girls' soccer will go against Bakersfield Tourney at Bakersfield. Varsity boys basketball has a game against St. John Bosco Tourney at TBA. JV boys basketball and also has a game against Serrano at Serrano. In order to see how their season is going, make sure to come to our games and support our fellow athletes. Lastly, everyone should go out and support our Rough and Tuff teams. The Rough and Tuff games will begin after school in the gym at 4 p.m. and tickets are only $3. Come to the games and support your class to cheer them on and see who will come out as this year's champions.
As one of the junior players on this year's Rough and Tuff team, how do you feel about your chances of winning?
I think we're doing pretty good. You know, I've never played volleyball before, like in my life, but I mean, can we put the camera on them real fast?
I feel like you could see how it's probably gonna go, so I'm pretty excited for the match.
Okay, now Matthew, they were talking some major smack, like about your team, how you're gonna go down, how you're gonna lose. What do you have to say in response to that?
I don't know, maybe like put them in a calculus class or something, see how they do first, and then, you know. I feel like us juniors just have more like experience with life, let alone volleyball, you know.
You know, that's very valid. Yeah. Thank you so much.
No problem.
I mean, it is what it is. It'll all come down to the actual game.
Thank you for that interesting clip, ASB. Make sure to come and support, and don't forget to bring your school spirit with you. I sure do hope Gryffindor wins. That also reminds me, that won't be the only ball getting served. I have another joke, and this one will stump you for sure. What can you serve but never eat? A tennis ball. Well, that's all for the announcements for me today. Remember to follow us on Instagram at Scorpion News for more content. Thank you for tuning in. Have a great rest of your week. This is Sabrina, the Teenage Elf, signing off.
Hello. This week's word of the week is spendthrift. The definition is a person who spends money in an extravagant, irresponsible way.
Hi.
Just this, please.
I'm a sword.
Oh my god.
Why do you need so many swords?
Why don't I?
Such a spendthrift.